It was very interesting when after I wrote my book, there were a number of people who contacted me. Some people just about the book, but some people who had ideas for creative projects. And when I got Hector's email, I thought, this is a fantastic idea. And it wasn't so much about promoting my theory, but what I liked was that it was a different way of telling a story about physics. You know, I thought really hard about how to turn it into a linear story that you can present in a book. And suddenly this idea of having music where you could have many different voices, and specifically music with voices themselves, with an opera, you know, to have the voices of the music and the voices of the opera, sounded so exciting, and it had never occurred to me. I mean, I have some interaction with artists who are visual artists, but the idea to do it with sounds and with music and with voices, just it sounded like just the right kind of thing at the right time. I felt like the world was sort of ready for such a thing in some sense. And also, Hector really, it was clear when I read the email that Hector really did understand the physics that I was presenting, that it was something that he had really thought about. It wasn't just like, oh, wow, physics, let's put it together with music. It was something that he really had some ideas about how to proceed. And also, but, you know, of course, I still didn't know if this would work. It's a very new and different thing. And, you know, I wanted to listen to his music and see, is it the kind of music that could work with these ideas? And did I like the music? Which I did, fortunately. So it was the beginning of a process. I mean, we went back and forth about what it is, but we really seemed to have the same idea about what we wanted to do. We wanted to express something about what sort of drives creativity, what drives a project forward, what drives ideas. And that was what, you know, something that really had the idea of what it means to be a composer or be a scientist in it, that, you know, was something that really wasn't yet expressed in the world, but also that we could sort of express the ideas through music. There just seemed to be so many possibilities, so it seemed worth exploring.
When I read word passages, I had really a strong, a very deep vibration, emotional vibration, a static vibration in my feelings, that I really saw there the possibility to create a new world of sound, a new structure, a new musical structure, in terms of parallelism, structural parallelism with the inner theories of physical world of Lisa. And what I really projected on my mind during the reading, the first reading of the book, was that these parallels in a structure between sounding world, dramatic activity in the opera, and physical models, I mean explanations of the reality, would provoke to the potential public a new kind of emotion, a new kind of approaching the reality of the concert hall. So what I really saw, the possibility to interact in a very profound level, that means a static approach, that means cognitive approach, and artistic, of course, in such a way that concrete aspects of this brain world and these specific theories of Lisa and Raman can be the basement, the whole world that inspires a new kind of opera. So the connection between the sound, the public, and the reality we live during an opera, so the cathartic, the catharsis as a highest point, could be working like that with Lisa of a new nature, of another kind of nature. And this catharsis would be pushed by psychoacoustic more than dramatic.
You know, on the one hand, it's rather uncomfortable having your physics theories in an artistic work, and I was uncomfortable doing this particular thing. But what I think Hector made clear, what was also sort of clear, is that sort of having this geometry was a very nice visual form to be able to do something like this. So a lot of the time we work on particle physics, it's very internal. Having this kind of spatial structure opened up opportunities, both literally and metaphorically, to, you know, that you could explore the space, but also that the space could represent just sort of looking out into the world and looking for new ideas. It was a very exciting possibility to have this contrast between sort of the lower dimensional and higher dimensional world, where the higher dimensional world could represent all ideas in some sense. And also the particular things going on in that space, the idea that forces might unify as you moved in the space. I mean, again, it was just a very nice geometry to sort of represent these ideas. So it just seemed that this warp geometry, both in having an extra dimension, having warping, and having this idea that maybe things unify, was just a very nice visual forum to try to incorporate some of these ideas.